Welcome back to CTV. Let's start with the Snow Week preview.
This week on CTV, we did a Snow Week preview. Let's check it out!
I'm here with
Elliot.
And what are the Snow Week dress-up days?
Monday is going to be grout fit, and then Tuesday's jersey. Wednesday is going to be the snow fit day, and then Thursday is going to be anything but a backpack day and whiteout, and then seniors can wear their college attire. And then Friday is country versus country club.
Thank you. I'm here with
Tyler.
And
Kai.
And can you tell us a little bit about Bring Your Snowmobile to School Day?
Yeah, so everyone on Wednesday can ride their snowmobiles to school, any grade 9 through 12, and we'll have parking spots that you can park in and areas that you should stay out of.
Okay. Make sure you get to school on time. That's a big thing.
I'm here with
Keaton.
And Keaton, can you tell me a little bit about Snow Week Coronation?
Yeah, so Coronation will be held the Monday of Snow Week. It will be held in the pack during flex time, and there will be 5 boy candidates and 5 girl candidates that are voted on by the staff and teachers, and student council will host a little game before we announce who the king and queen are, and then we will crown the king and queen, and then that'll pretty much be it.
Perfect. I'm here with Jenna, and can you tell me a little bit about the assembly?
Yeah, so it's on Friday during flex. We're gonna watch a video that will show a recap of Snow Week, and we're gonna play a game, and you're gonna hear a little bit from the winter sports and activities.
Thank you.
I'm here with Mr. Johnson. Can you tell us about the class activities for Snow Week?
Right now the plans are that the freshmen are gonna be going over to Sioux Falls roller skating. The sophomores will be going over to Sioux Falls to go bowling. The juniors will be heading over to the ice arena to go skating, and then the seniors will be going to Great Bear to do some tubing there. One of the things we do want every high school student to do, though, is to sign up. They need to sign up if they're going to be going to that event, or if not, if they choose not to, we will have study halls here that they can also be, but they do need to be here. Everyone does need to be here in school and either participate in the student activity or the study hall. The other thing that they'll need to do, too, is they'll need to pay a little fee just to help out with the cost of the activity. So the sign up, I do believe, is going to be the week of January 22nd to the 26th. So
make sure to participate in all of the dress up days and activities. Back to the nest.
Can't wait for those class activities and to dress up next week. Now let's go to the Whisper Challenge.
This week on CTV, we checked out the Whisper Challenge. Let's check it out.
Today I'm here with
Caden Kruger,
Raiden Boinga,
and we're doing the Whisper Challenge.
Can I have your number?
What?
Can I have
get
have
your
mine
your
your.
Me.
No, yours. Like, yours.
Yours.
Yours. Wait. Number.
What?
Number.
7?
Okay. Number.
Oh, number?
Yeah.
Can I have your number?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Go. Take it easy.
What? Repeat it.
Take it easy.
Say it.
Take it easy.
Bro, I don't know.
Take it easy.
Say it.
Take it easy.
Something easy?
Take it easy.
Take it?
Yeah.
Take it easy?
Yeah.
Yes!
Saved by the bell.
Say that again.
Saved by the bell.
Math?
Saved by the bell.
I have no idea. Say it again.
Saved by the bell.
Saved by the bell?
Wow, that was super cool. Back to the nest.
Now let's check out the new club at LHS.
Welcome back. This week we're going to be checking out the Diversity Club. Check it out. All right, here with Adam. He is a clubbie of the Diversity Club, and tell us a little bit about it.
So there's a bunch of people in the club, Rosalind Hartshorn and this other lady, they run it. So you sit down in the class and you talk about different topics. So a topic, for example, could be racism. Where is it? What could it, happens to people when it happens to them? Just topics like that.
Sounds good. Thank you.
I'm here with Rosalind, and she's going to tell us more about the Diversity Club.
Okay, so I created the Diversity Club because I wanted our school to be more inclusive to all other races, because I know there is a lot of people of color here at Laverne. So I thought it was a great way to embrace that.
Thank you. And how can you attend the club?
You can go to Miss Goldsmith's room on Tuesdays during Flex.
Thank you. Who am I here with?
Miss Goldsmith.
And Miss Goldsmith, where is your room located?
I am in the upstairs wing of the high school. My room is 2606, which is on the west side of the hallway.
And what are some of the topics that you talk about in this club?
Well, we'll be covering issues related to different cultures that are present in our high school, as well as promoting celebrations of contributions made by different members of American society. We'll be following similar themes that the government has set up, like for Women's History Month or Arab American Month.
Thank you.
Thank you for starting Diversity Club. Back to the nest.
Pretty cool. Let's check out what people's last meals would be.
Today, we asked people's last meal request. Let's check it out.
I'm here with
Mr. Weber.
And Mr. Weber, what would you have for a last meal request?
My last meal request would be tacos made by my mom, and then also like an Oreo Blizzard or an Oreo ice cream or something like that.
And why is that?
Because it's my mom's food and she does a good job cooking it, and Oreo Blizzards are amazing.
Thank you.
I'm here with
Lincoln.
And Lincoln, what would your last meal be?
Chicken tenders from Quick Trip.
And why's that?
Because it was Chicken Wednesday and they were on sale.
Thank you.
I'm here with
Garrett.
And Garrett, what is your last meal request?
Tuna noodle casserole.
And why?
Because my mom used to make it.
Thank you.
I'm here with
Logan Mann.
And Logan, what would your last meal be?
Probably steak potatoes.
And why is that?
It's a good meal.
Well, thank you.
I'm here with
Abby Bulges.
Abby, what would your last meal be and why?
The Caney Egg combo from Cane's, but swap out the coleslaw. Toast. Because it's good.
Thank you. I'm here with
Reagan Melhoff.
And Reagan, what would your last meal be?
I had a chicken salad at Haley's house.
Why?
Because they're good and I like them.
Wow, some good reasons. Wow, that's pretty interesting. Back to the nest.
Those sound pretty good. Now let's get a mock trial update.
This week on CTV, we're going to be checking out how the mock trial season is going so far. Let's check it out.
Who am I here with?
Kylie.
And Kylie, what is your position in mock trial?
I'm a lawyer for the defense.
And how has your season gone so far?
I'd say it's going pretty good.
What is your favorite part about mock trial?
Getting to be in a courtroom and just like seeing how a trial works.
Very cool. Thank you.
Who am I here with?
Xavier McKenzie.
And Xavier, what is your part in mock trial?
I'm the main defendant, Rainey Smiley, who's been accused of dumping chemicals in the water.
And how has your season gone so far?
Pretty good. We just had our first trial yesterday. We lost only by 3 points, but we're a pretty young team, so I think we're vastly improving already.
And what is your favorite part?
I'd say my favorite part is really just the team aspect of it, and how we get to communicate and form inside jokes. You know, we were talking about being able to stand on business at our trial, so I think we're doing that the rest of the season.
Thank you.
Who am I here with?
Tyler Hodge.
And Tyler, what is your position in mock trial?
I'm a lawyer.
How has the season gone so far?
Going pretty good so far. We had our first competition on Thursday, and it was close.
And what is your favorite part about mock trial?
Probably making new friends throughout different grades.
Fantastic, thank you.
Good luck to the rest of the season in mock trial.
Back to the nest.
Mock trial. Let's go play the name game.
This week on CTV, we asked people the first name that comes to mind.
Check it out.
Name a guy.
Januszewski.
Landon, name a girl.
Ella.
Okay, Augusta, name a guy.
Gavin.
No. Gavin, who is the first girl that comes to mind?
Augusta.
Name a guy.
Kane Jurens.
Name a girl.
Ella.
Who's the first guy that comes to mind?
Mr. Robs.
Name a girl.
Hannah.
Who is the first guy that comes to mind?
Ronald Reagan.
One question.
Yep. Who's the first woman that comes to mind?
My wife.
Tori, name a guy.
Mr. Perkins.
Back to the nest.
That was pretty funny. Now on to sports.
On Tuesday, the boys traveled to Waseca to take on New Prague. They lost 5-6. Patrick Kroski had 4 points with 3 goals and an assist, and Elliot Domagala had 3 points with a goal and 2 assists. On Tuesday, the boys played Jackson, beating them 80-69. Landon Arndt had a double-double with 23 points and 10 rebounds. Carter Sayre also had 23 points. Also on Tuesday, the girls traveled to Jackson, losing 59-69. Kira John had 21 points and 8 rebounds, and Kayla Blumendahl had 6 assists.
On Tuesday, the wrestling team had a meet in Windham, with the team winning 35-29 against Wabasso, losing 21-46 against Windham, and losing to Worthington 24-35. They also had a meet in Lenox, winning 63-6 against Roosevelt and winning 48-22 against Lenox. On Thursday, the gymnastics team traveled to Jackson, winning 130-126.
Sports, let's check out your favorite memories of last year.
This week on CTV, we checked out people's favorite memories from 2023. Let's check it out. Here with
Morgan Jonas.
And what was your favorite memory of 2023?
Going to races with my friend Ava.
Nice. I'm here with
Kylie
and Macy.
And what was your guys' favorite memory of 2023?
State softball.
Seeing Emma. I'm here with
Andrew Deitch.
Brendan Snyders.
And what's your favorite memory from 2023?
Probably winning a varsity match in Viber Curly.
Going camping with my family.
Nice. I'm here with
Gemma.
And what was your favorite memory from 2023?
This summer I had a lot of fun.
Nice. I'm here with
Mr. Sickmiller.
And what's your favorite memory from 2023?
I would have to say golfing in Arizona last spring. What do we got? Easter break? Easter break last year. Golfing. Good.
Nice. Back to the nest.
You guys had a good year. Thanks for watching. See you next week.